Hey guys, welcome back. Well, it is almost 8 o'clock Monday night, and if I'm not working or have family obligations, I always try and check into the Beaverton CertNet, and I thought I'd bring you along one more time. Got the radio all tuned and ready to go. While we're waiting, I thought this would be a good opportunity to go over my 2-meter go bag. Now, go bag is basically everything you need that you can grab and take very quickly for portable communications. This bag supports my Yaesu VX8-R 2-meter dual band handheld. And I thought this would be a good time to go over this kit because it really has turned out to be quite satisfactory for me. And I've shown it in some other videos but haven't had a chance to do a detailed review. So while we're waiting for 8 o'clock to come around and check into Beaverton CertNet, let's go through my 2-meter handheld go bag. Okay, well this is my 2-meter go bag and it's based on a County COMM EOD bag, which is perfect for a go bag. On the outside is a nice little place to carry a business card and identification label. I carry my card so I can pass these on to other hams. Has my call sign and contact information. I picked this up at US Calvary and it is MOLLE compatible and it clips on here very nicely. Now on the bottom I've run through the MOLLE webbing a set of CPVC pipes that have a cap on one end and a removable red vinyl cap, and that's where I keep spare antennas. They're held in place with a couple of bongo ties and they stay in place very nicely. I painted them with Duracoat and they've held up very nicely. I've thrown this in my truck, it sits on the floor and you can't even see any wear. Alright, let's go through the contents here really quick. And actually before we get into the contents, I just want to put a shout out to John at Tactical Gearhead and also another YouTube channel that he runs, W9ROL, and that's his call sign. And thanks very much, John. This has been a perfect addition to my go bag. Clearly identifies it right from the top. All right, inside, I've got a scanner, and this is sitting in a very nice radio pouch from 511. And it works perfect. It's MOLLE compatible. Can also go on your belt. And it really protects my scanner. I've got this scanner set to all the public service frequencies in our area. Fire, law enforcement, and ambulance, as well as the hospital HeartNet. The main component for this go bag is my Yaesu VX8-R, which I've talked about in other videos. I like to keep the speaker mic on, and on top of the speaker mic, I always keep the GPS module, and this allows me with the APRS function to track online where I am. In this bag, and this is just one of those Husky zip bags, you can get them from Home Depot. I took the zip pull off and just put a little piece of paracord. This is where I keep my charger and also my auto charger. The next bag, and this is empty right now, this is another one of those Husky bags. They come in a set of three, the black, the gray, and the red. This is where I keep my speaker mic when I'm not using it. Now inside the EOD bag, on the back wall, you can see there are two pockets. In this pocket, I have the red zipper pouch, also from Home Depot. Remember, they come in a set of three, black, gray, and red. The red is my power pack. So in here, I've got an extra lithium power pack for my radio, as well as the clamshell for AA batteries. And then I carry two sets of lithium AA batteries. That should keep me going for quite a while. Now the other pouch is where I keep a notebook with a Fisher Space pen and a Write in the Rain tablet with water-resistant paper. This is a great place to write down contacts, radio frequencies, etc. And then last but not least, in that pocket I carry the repeater directory. This one is for 2010, 2011. This is put out by ARRL, and it fits very nicely in this lock sack bag, which keeps it waterproof. Now inside on a key ring, on a dog tag that I had printed at U.S. Calvary, I've got my personal identification, phone number, email, and call sign. If this bag gets out of my control, I'm hoping that someone will be honest and use this information to get it back to me. In this lock sack bag, I have the NIFTY mini manual for my VX8-R, and I also have
extra items that I carry in that pocket. Scanner.
This is the adapter cable for the VX8-R that has the SMA adapter on one end and the PL259 on the other end. I also keep a compass on a lanyard. That's been very helpful when making contacts with satellites, so you know what direction. And it's just, in general, a good policy to have an extra compass. This is the shoulder strap for the EOD bag. And then this is the factory antenna set for my VX8-R. All right, there you have it. That's a very nice portable go bag. And if you're interested in something similar, a good place to start is this EOD bag from COMM.